It's a bloody outrage. Anyone know the name of the road?
Beach Road, is it,
I'm not sure, actually. Oh, they're here. Who we got missing, anybody? Maybe Boris will appear. Where's old Pete? Don't say no, 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 no. Just say yeah, 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 yeah. And we'll go, 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 go. If you're ready, like I'm ready. Cause it's a beautiful night. We're looking for something dumb to do. Hey, baby, I think I wanna marry you. I'm feeling okay. Quite happy, really.
Nervous?
Not really. What for? Been with me wombat too long.
Gathered here today to celebrate the marriage of Simon and Sharon and to witness their vows of matrimony. Simon, may I have your full name, please?
Simon James Henry.
And Sharon, may I have your full name, please?
Sharon Elizabeth Kingston.
Thank you. If any person here present knows of any lawful impediment to this marriage, they should declare it now.
I knew they'd all do that. I thought they'd all organise that.
Before you are joined in matrimony,
uh-huh,
I am required by law to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows you are about to make.
To hear.
Marriage, according to the law of this country, is the union of two people voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. Simon, please reply, I am, to the following question.
Okay.
Are you, Simon James Henry?
Oh, I am.
Free?
Wait.
He's too keen, isn't he?
There's cake back at the other place.
Ah, you'd have to be somewhere.
A bit of cake, yeah.
free, I will start again. Are you, Simon James Henry, free lawfully to marry Sharon Elizabeth Kingston?
I am.
Thank you. And Sharon, would you please reply, I am, to the following question. Are you, Sharon Elizabeth Kingston, free lawfully to marry Simon James Henry?
I am.
Simon,
yes.
Would you please repeat after me to Sharon? I, Simon James Henry.
I, Simon James Henry.
Take you.
Take you.
Sharon Elizabeth Kingston.
Sharon Elizabeth Kingston.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
And Sharon, would you please repeat after me to Simon? I, Sharon Elizabeth Kingston.
I, Sharon Elizabeth Kingston.
Take you.
Take you.
Simon James Henry.
Simon James Henry.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
Okay. Now it's time to move on to the rings. Would you place Sharon's ring onto the third finger of her left hand and just hold it there a moment and then repeat this vow after me. I give you this ring.
I'll give you this ring.
As a token of the love we share.
As a token of the love we share.
And the vows that we have made here today.
And the vows that we have made here today. That fitted.
As if you had it made for you.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Okay, and then Sharon, would you place Simon's ring onto the third finger of his left hand, hold it there, and repeat this vow after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a token of the love we share.
As a token of the love we share.
And the vows we have made here today.
And the vows we have made here today.
Brilliant.
Simon and Sharon, you have both made the declarations prescribed by law and have made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your witnesses. We hope that this feeling of love you have for each other will deepen and grow ever stronger throughout all of the years to come.
Sure it will.
Simon and Sharon, it is now my very, very great pleasure to announce that you are husband and wife.
Simon, oh, it's gone. We'll do it all, everything on our
for our bride and groom, Simon and Sharon.
If I lay here, if I just lay here, would you lie with me and just forget the world?
How are you both feeling?
Looking forward to the cake.
Always look forward to the cake.
Yeah. Time to relax.
You can photograph this now. Everyone look into the camera and say, do you know it? Face the front, face the music.
Your sound is
I'll make you famous.
That every life must be end, uh-huh. As we sit alone, I know someday we must go. Oh, I'm a lucky man to count on both hands the ones I love. Some folks just have one, yeah, others they got none. Oh,
oh. Penis. Can I have another word other than penis?
Oh, I'll do me best. Thank you very much.
Ooh!
How happy everyone is when they play boobies.
Practice stomach skins, never gonna let me win. Oh, oh. Under everything, just another human being. Oh, oh. Yeah, I don't wanna hurt. There's so much in this world to make me bleed. Stay with me, oh, all I see. Did I say that I need you? Did I say that I want you? Or if I didn't, I'm a fool, you see. No one knows this more than me.
Look at you. You're great.
Normally in the wedding card, I always write my oil ups and downs between the sheets. But I know, as you said, you're a bit past that. So my oil ups and downs be in your head, mate. Best of luck.
This is a short message for Sharon and Simon Henry, my old friends. They're very fantastic. Congratulations for at last getting married. About bloody time.
How are you feeling now, Si?
Knackered already. Boring, really, this marriage lot. It's kind of right, really.
is like a Southern Troopers interview.
It's worse. It's worse than a Southern Troopers interview because I feel like it's all about me.
There is no escape.
Good job we had a fag first.
Very, very warm welcome to you all to this very special occasion today. I've taken part in hundreds of weddings, but I have to say, that thing that came down the aisle first is probably the ugliest bridesmaid I've ever seen. This is a happy occasion. As we know, Sharon and Simon married this morning. Today they've asked me to do this service of prayer for all of you, because they want all of you to be a part of today, to share in their joy, to celebrate openly their love for each other. And what means most to them is the fact that all of you are here. You will never have been taken part in a wedding service of prayer like this, and I can guarantee to you, till your dying day, you'll never go through one of these again. Because we've put this service together, parts of it from Sharon and Simon, and parts of it from me. And we're going to start by them exchanging their vows, which I've printed out for them.
Love me without fear, trust me without questioning, need me without demanding, want me without restrictions, accept me without change, desire me without inhibitions, for a love so free will never fly away.
Take those away with you. And then we've got you might think, strange thing, but we're going to have, as a part of this, an Apache blessing. And the only people we haven't got in today are cowboys and Indians, but we've got all these other strange people. So use your imagination, please. Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be shelter to the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth to the other. Now there is no more loneliness for you, for each of you will be a companion to the other. Now you are two bodies, but there is only one before you now. Go now to your dwelling place, to enter into the days of your togetherness, and may your days be good and long while you're both here on this earth. And the one thing they did this morning was exchange wedding rings. Now there's an important symbol of wedding rings, and it goes back about 6,000 years. They used to be made of ivory. They're always put on the same finger. I have a wedding ring. I'm married to the Lord. I used to be a monk, so I've remained celibate for the rest of my life. But it's exactly the same principle of exchanging vows. And the wedding rings were placed on the forefinger because history says that finger has the largest vein in the hand, and it goes straight to the heart. The rings must never be seen as a prize or a symbol of ownership, but rather as a sign of unbroken unity, unending changelessness. The ring is a perfect round. It has no entry point and it has no exit point. Sharon and Simon, what I would like to ask you is that you often look at your wedding rings in your life together, especially in the ups and the downs, because anyone that stands in front of the bride and groom and tells you it's all sunshine and roses would be a liar. Every wedding, every marriage has its ups and its downs. When you get those, look at your wedding ring. Remember today, because today is a brand new thing. Because today you're not two people, you are one couple. Sharon and Simon have asked me to bless their wedding rings, and I'm going to do this with holy water that comes from the miraculous shrine at Lourdes, where all the miracles take place. Heavenly Father, we ask you to bless these rings. Grant to those who've exchanged them, may they have a deep faith in each other today and for all the days of their lives. I ask you now to exchange your first gift as husband and wife. You have given and received one of the most precious gifts of life, one I know that you will always remember. Each flower represents an individual, but together they make something much better. Each flower is given by a member of a family or as a friend. That love unites the giver also with the bride and the groom. Where there is love, the heart is light. Where there is love, the day is bright. Where there is love, there is a song to help you both when things go wrong. Where there is love, there is a smile to make all things seem more worthwhile. Where there is love, there's quiet peace, a tranquil place where turmoil cease. Love changes darkness into light and makes the heart beat with delight. Oh, blessed are you who walk in love. You also walk with God above.
Hi, Sharon and Simon. Congratulations. Thank you for the invitation. And it was great to be here. Wishing you all the best for the future.
Yeah, I have to second that. Thanks for inviting us. Great to be here. We remember our time, Sharon, back in both Belgium and the Netherlands, and trying to fit into culture there. It's amazing how we managed to fit in with Cornish culture, which is something else altogether. And yeah, we're from Yorkshire, so we understand these big differences. You're doing brilliantly, you're with really good people, and you're blossoming. It's great to see you two together. Wonderful. We've really enjoyed today, and we look forward to seeing you enjoying yourselves for the rest of your lives together. Thank you.
Let me know when you're ready. Are we ready? It's a bloody outrage. Thank you. Appreciate it. Don't start me laughing.
congratulations, Simon and Sharon. Thank you very much for inviting us. I wish you tons and tons of happiness and good wishes. I'm sure that you'll be, well, I don't need to tell you, I know that you'll be more than happy together. And just love you.
Congratulations.
Lots. Many hugs and kisses, and the bears love you very much.
Put your hand out, Gary.
Sorry, I can't see.
Yeah. Come on. Come on. Hi, Simon. Hi, Sharon. I'd just like to congratulate you today on your wedding, and that'll come on my behalf as well as Lynn and TJ. I'll speak for both of us when I say congratulations. I hope you had a great day. I didn't go to the wedding exactly, but I hope it went well for you, and you had a great, a lot of people come to see you and get married, and it must have been one of the happiest days of your life, because when I got married, it was for me as well. Thank you for looking out for me, and you've always been there to back me up and see that I've never got in trouble, and you've always been there for me, Simon, so thank you very much for everything that you've done for me. I'm very grateful.
Hope you have a lot more luck in the future than you've had in the past.
And start again. Gordon.
Hope you have a lot more luck in the future than you've had in the past. And I hope everything goes well between you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
It's been a brilliant day. thanks for having us.
And you both were amazing.
Well done, Neil. I thought you were going to chicken out then.
Hi, Si and Shaz. I hope you had a brilliant day. We've had a good time. It's been about the filming being a bit shoddy for your wedding, but we can fix that. Oh, harder.
Oh, good
night. Bloody hell. Have a good day. Love you lots. Bye.
Best wishes to both of you as well. All of us. And Molly. Don't forget Molly.
May the force be with you.
Excellent.
Hope you've had a great day. I hope you can hear me. Sharon, your hen night is still a secret.
Love to you both.
Hello, Simon and Sharon. I hope you have had a wonderful day. You know, we love you. And may the force be with you. And of course, Tony Blair would like to say, I'm hoping you have a wonderful, wonderful day and enjoy the cake as well. And I love this guy. He loves you all too. I don't remember who he is. What's his name?
Rob.
Rob! He can speak in all, eh? He can speak, he can. I'll say.
This video is going to be awful.
Christmas!
And a Happy New Year. Now, you know we love you lots, and we're really happy that you've had a good day.
Yep.
And hope you have a really good life together.
Don't spend too long in bed, the pair of you.
Nah.
Honestly, you two, you're well made. Enjoy your life.
Yeah, have a good one. We're always here for you, and you know that.
Love you.
Love you always. Bye for now.
Beautiful. I've been told to get your speech now.
Yada, yada, yada.
Oh, I say, how are you?
It's good to see you guys. Hope you have a wonderful time. I've just seen you in there. We're going to keep drinking and be merry, but only water, as we don't drink alcohol. You know.
Hi, Simon, Sharon. Congratulations for a wonderful day. I've had good fun. But Gary is a bit of a knob. I hope you have a lovely life together. Thanks.
Fantastic.
Which bit?
Gary's a knob.
You better not to be with you.
Congratulations, Simon and Sharon. I hope you have a lovely, long, fruitful marriage. I know you will. You're a lovely couple, made for each other. Sharon, I think you know what you're taking on. But Simon, do you know what you're taking on? All the best.
Thank you, Sharon, for all your help, and Simon for all your help for all the times that we've been trooping with you. I miss you, but good luck in your marriage. Love you to bits.
Gail Felicitier.
Maddie Hulick.
Maddie Hulick.
Congratulations with your marriage.
May the force be with you always.
Hello, Simon, Sharon. Congratulations on your wedding, and I hope you all the best for the future. Bless the pair of you. Love and respect, Rob.
Sharon, I think the best thing that's happened to Simon, I think you suit each other perfectly. He needed you to come to his life, as I told you before on the phone, without him now, remember? I love you both to bits.
Live long and prosper, and may the force be with you, as we've always said. Congratulations to you both, we love you lots. Cheers!
Congratulations, and R2 enjoyed his day here today with you, and thank you for inviting us.
Say it.
It's nearly 8 o'clock at night, nearly bedtime, so I think I ought to go and tuck myself up in bed. Everyone else has gone. Listen to how slurred he is right now. Not slurred at all, it's just he's got slow motion on the camera.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and knock on us so hard. It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars and we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah. words just might find their way into my dreams tonight. But I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between. With only two, just me and you, not so many things we got to do or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.
Australians for coming all the way from Australia. Yay! Have a safe trip back. Yay! Belgians for coming all the way from Belgium. Woo! Yay! The other long distance travellers, I won't list them all, but there's some from Norwich, there's some from Yorkshire, London,
Plymouth,
next door, Portsmouth, Southampton,
Chippenham.
Right, that's enough of that rubbish, right. Well, I want to thank everybody who helped us set up last night and today, especially in our absence while we were busy getting married, doing the legal bit. Boring. the hall and all that, yeah. And to help me serving the food, thank you very much Jamie Lee and Angela for the cakes, and those brilliant cakes. All the costumers. Thanks, Yannick, in particular, for wearing Chewy. I know that's awful. Thank you very much to Pete for organising the, whatever it was, not a card, yeah. You could tell I had a drink here. oh yeah, and George for the R2. Thanks for leaving it with me. It'd be an easier drive home without it. Well, I've got about half the parts so far, so I've got another half the parts. Charles have to come down and help me make one.
Yeah, that's all right.
Is that all right?
Yeah.
You can get rid of him then for a while.
Oh,
yeah, you can come, yeah.
Thanks.
Well, I could send Sharon up with you, but Charles come down to me and we'll draw the R2. Yeah, she'd be happy. Yeah. She's an Australian, she's there recently, please. That's why I married by her. Oh yes, where are we? Karen for helping with the dress. Thank you very much. Elaine, who's not here, but for all the flowers. Kate Blake's Angela and Jamie Lee, like I said. Bins and Liz, wherever you are.
Love you, Aaron. Oh, yeah,
Chris, yes. Chris and Zoe for filming. We'll all get the pleasure of one of those DVDs one day. We don't charge too much for those. Right. Oh, yeah, so the Legion staff. Thank you very much for the Legion staff. And it is at this point I'd like to remind you that the Legion staff are volunteers in this place. So if anyone wants to give them a tip, please feel free to do so. Alright? I want to thank little Sean and little Lily. They did a superb job. Let me just drag the chair in a second. Oh yes, oh yeah, thank everybody for all the gifts. Sharon just reminded me of that. I must have skipped that bit. Oh yes. On this table here you'll have our family photos. Sharon's dad unfortunately died last month, is it? A couple of weeks ago. So Russell's there with Sharon's stepmum Indra and Noel and Sharon's mum Gail, and then my mum and dad Jackie and John.
There we
go. We thought we'd bring them to the park. They're probably with us anyway, but we thought we'd bring them. Right, done that bar tipping business. Where are we now? Any words on the floor? What's that? I've done that. Oh yes, there's plenty of food, just dig in, because Sharon bought loads of it.
And there's nothing there yet. We've got chicken, we've got vegetarian, we've got meatballs,
we've got a lot of hot food that's going to come out of the kitchen and out of our house, so please, eat it. Because otherwise I've got to eat the bloody stuff.
You told me to eat something before I came out here.
If you could start with the chicken, I'd be grateful because I don't eat chicken. Oh yes, and over here also, if you haven't already noticed, there's a guest book for you to sign, and there's a donation box if you want to put a few pence in there. Right, what else have I got to do? Oh yes, and I have to thank Sharon, obviously. Well, I can thank Sharon. Well, that concludes today's speech. Thank you very much.